Hi friends, welcome back to another episode of Generation Films. My name is Alan. One of the things I really think separates the John Wick movies from other more standard action flicks is the fascinating underworld in which John Wick operates in. Secret high-end gunsmiths, bespoke tailors specializing in bullet-resistant materials, and of course the continental chain of hotels all make the world seem all that more realistic. I actually highly recommend the Continental brand hotel chain if you are staying in a more dangerous city. It's a great way to avoid homicides. Anyway, the world of John Wick will have you believe that there's a relatively large and complex criminal economy that functions independently from the one we normies use. Instead of using paper money like we do, their money is backed by gold. Literally, that's what the coins are made out of. Which is kind of smart. There's no need to protect some giant vault of gold, which back some phony money. A giant gold vault would especially be a big liability when your currency is solely used by scumbags and killers. Now, this entire economic system was set up by what's known as the High Table. They're kind of this mysterious organization that stabilizes the entire underworld and sets up parameters and rules for all of these contract killers to follow. They're the ones who set up the Continental Chain Hotels and enforce the safe haven rules as well. They're also the ones who mint the gold and distribute them. Now, we're never told just how much these gold coins are worth, but occasionally we do see Wick and other assassins make purchases. Today, we're going to analyze those scenes and use a few other clues from the movie and outside sources to determine just how much one gold coin is worth. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification button down below. Every time someone subscribes, we donate a dollar to Dolphin Unsafe Tuna. So right away, we can tell this coin is roughly the size of a 1 ounce American Gold Eagle coin, perhaps a tiny bit larger. These coins contain 1 ounce of pure gold, which is worth around $1,300 on the market right now. If the coins from John Wick are pure gold, then we would have to expect that these coins are worth at least a few hundred dollars more than $1,300, maybe even a few thousand. Otherwise, people would just melt down these coins and sell the gold. Although we're not 100% sure, though, if these John Wick coins are actually fully made out of pure gold. They could be gold-plated, for instance. But for now, let's use the price point of, say, $1,500 for one gold coin and see if it all adds up. One of the first times we see John Wick use the coin is at the Continental Hotel. The cost of a stay is just one gold coin for 2 days. Which is actually pretty cheap considering the fact that the average 5-star hotel room costs about $1,000 a night in New York City. The Continental Hotel should, in theory, be much more expensive than your average hotel. They provide a lot more services than just a good concierge desk, a pool, and a gym. For one, there's the intense amount of security employed by the Continental, which guarantees that no fighting actually takes place at the hotel. Peace of mind could be priceless for an assassin who is constantly looking over their shoulder. Also, there are several shops and services within the Continental that can be vital to a contractor's mission, from the disposal of bodies to weapons. Although all these services also cost money as well, which is maybe why the price point of the hotel is so cheap. Just like in a casino, the idea is to get people through the door so that they can spend money on all the different services within the casino. What about the other costs? Well, after John murks an entire hit squad sent to his house, about a dozen gunmen, he pays a cleanup crew about a dozen coins to make that mess disappear. $1,500 per body seems like a reasonable price to pay. The service includes multiple cleaners who are quite professional at what they do. They not only tidy up the house and repair any damage made, they also take the bodies and get rid of them, which, as we all know, well, not me, I don't know, is probably a very hard thing to do. Access to the club and the restaurant in the basement is one coin as well. This is where things get a bit confusing. $1,500 is a bit too much for any kind of cover for a nightclub, even in New York. But let's say you want to get bottle service or a VIP table, then $1,500 could be the minimum you would spend. But this brings me to another point. When Wick encounters Barada, the man in charge of minting the gold coins, he reminds Wick that these gold coins aren't just currency, but also representative of a social contract. Again, the value set forth by the High Table permeates into every aspect of the criminal underworld. And I think that rule and authority appeals to these contractors who live in constant chaos. It's something they're willing to pay a premium for. After all, the hitmen in this world are the best of the best, and therefore their clientele are also the highest paying. An early hit on John Wick is placed at $2 million. In comparison, in our real world, in a country like Peru, assassinations can cost as low as a few hundred dollars. So money for the assassins in John Wick and the ones in the Continental restaurant is not that big of an issue. They have plenty of money. And probably for most of their interactions in the world, they use regular currency with regular vendors. But when they come to the Continental or any other high table related enterprise, they're given the promise of safety, consistency, and exclusivity, which again is priceless for these type of individuals. So maybe it is worth one gold coin to be allowed to go into that club. It's the ability to pay for a safe place to drink, but also it's a place where you can be surrounded by like-minded professionals. No scrubs allowed. It's a place where business can be discussed as well and connections can be made. And just in case you were wondering, the drinks also cost money too. In John Wick 2, a fellow assassin buys John and himself two drinks for the lofty price of one gold coin. Although technically it was supposed to be the last drink for John, so the extra coinage and big tip was just a symbolic gesture of respect. Which brings me to my next point. The gold coins in John Wick is basically the only underworld currency we see. There are no other denominations like silver or bronze coins or smaller coins, which can be problematic. What happens when John Wick needs to buy something out of a vending machine? As much as we'd like to, there is no way to engineer or justify a Twix bar costing $1,500 unless it was like made out of Semtex or poisoned or something. Or what about when John Wick tells a taxi cab driver to take his dog back to the Continental from Midtown? That's no more than a $30 cab ride away. In that case, Wick also gives the cab driver one coin. So, like Beretta says, maybe these coins aren't just a currency, but a social contract, like a badge of honor of some kind. After all, assassins aren't just paid in gold coins, it seems. Contracts usually are given in dollar amounts as well. And if you really think about it, we never see the gold coins get exchanged for real money. As a matter of fact, that might be forbidden. The gold coins represent something much more, as we said. It's an exclusive token that shows that you're in with the crowd. Allowing regular people access to these coins would not only prove that the secret society exists, which would be a terrible thing for them, it would also limit the exclusivity of locations like the Continental and the bar and restaurant, which again is something that assassins are willing to pay for in the first place and would devalue the worth of the currency. Now, according to the directors of this film, the coins are actually more like business cards and the value of the coin fluctuates depending on who is holding it. For instance, John Wick's coins are going to be worth a lot more than some new assassin no one's ever heard of, which throws in a new twist in how the gold coins actually work. This means that there's no real set value besides maybe what the gold coin is worth in gold. It's an interesting system that is unlike any of our monetary systems we have in our world. If the worth of a gold coin depends more on how an individual is perceived, this is actually a great motivator for individuals to follow the rules and be honorable and good criminals, which would increase the value of their gold. On the other hand, a bad assassin or a general scumbag would be required to use more coins because their coins are worth less. This system actually works a lot like how influence works in the real world. For instance, let's say a company like Apple is looking to put a sponsor ad on Instagram. Whereas they'll be willing to pay me like $5 because I have a very small following on Instagram, they'll pay someone like Kim Kardashian hundreds of thousands of dollars because of her massive assfluence. This begins to make a lot of sense now as we look at what the gold coins are used for throughout the entire franchise. A gold coin is more of a unit of character than some kind of monetary sum. This breaks through the materialistic reliance of our world and focuses more on the quality and actions of an individual rather than their material worth. This really goes towards the emphasis of having honor amongst thieves, something that is rarely found outside the structure of normal society with its laws and enforcement. This is probably why the high table is so successful. They've created an economic system that encourages stability and good behavior. It's a society that attracts good and qualified and dependable assassins and criminals that won't cause problems for the rest of their society. And when one of the members of that society does break the rule, they get excommunicated. Their gold coins become worth nothing, and anyone dealing with them will suffer the gravest of consequences. What at first looks like a really cool but nonsensical currency makes complete sense when you detach it from our perception of monetary value. This currency is actually designed to be a lot smarter than I realized. It's all about honor. It's not just a currency, it's about a membership and an enforcement method as well. So there you have it, guys. Those are my thoughts about John Wick's currency. I'm sorry I couldn't come up with a monetary value, though. If you really do want one, I would say it's somewhere in the neighborhood of $1,500, which is probably its weight in gold. That would be like the set goal. I mean, if you're a complete scumbag, it might even be worth less. If you're John Wick, maybe it's worth two or three times. Who knows? Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Again, don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification button down below. As usual, thanks for joining us today. My name is Alan, reminding you that life is a movie, and you are the protagonist.